I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder. They'll eventually worm their way out on their own, but until they do, you're gonna be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Swinehart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy. Don't go looking for any more fights. Keep strain off your heart. And try and get some rest.
I can't take it easy. I have to find Crane.
Bigby? What's wrong?
Lack of sleep for one thing. Getting shot for another. He'll be fine. I had everyone that got wounded sent home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived. So I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper and spring water. Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do. Everything in moderation. And eat more chicken. Your blood pressure's through the proverbial roof.
I'll try to.
All right then. Very good.
Business office. I know. I'll have to call you back. The town is starting to find out.
Well, I'll leave you two to it then. Miss White? Bigby?
So, to recap...
Crane watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after him. And we know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters. That about cover it?
And once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be easy to catch Crane. So, I guess that's the plan, currently. But I don't know.
That's the plan? Just wait for the mirror?
It's all we have right now. What the hell is going on? I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this. I don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but do you really think Crane did it? Everything points to him, I get it, but do you really think he killed those women? Because it's just... it's incomprehensible to me.
From what I saw at the Open Arms, everything points to Crane murdering Lily. What isn't adding up for me is Faith. Why would he kill her? It doesn't seem connected.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense. He was a conniver, a coward, a liar. And I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts. But murdering prostitutes? Everything okay over there?
Yes, Miss White. I just cut myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
Thanks for tonight, by the way. That could have gone really terribly. I mean, even worse than it did. I'm glad you were there.
Anytime.
Can I, ask you a question? It's kind of personal. And I don't want to offend you, but after tonight, it's on my mind.
Why? What's on your mind?
It's just... when stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight, it feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home. And I've heard it said that maybe, in some tiny little bottled-up way, deep inside, you kind of... enjoy it when things go wrong. Because it gives you an excuse to just, you know, stop pretending.
Fuck no, I don't enjoy it. Are you kidding me? It's horrible what happened tonight. I wish it didn't happen.
I shouldn't have said anything. Forget that I did.
Hey guys? We have a problem.
What is it?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
What do you mean, missing a piece?
Yes, it's not here.
Crane must have taken a shard with him.
Oh, I can't believe this.
I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
Well, the mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Or what, Bufkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea how long that will take. We're just gonna have to do this the hard way.
I'm just saying, waiting is an option.
No. We can't depend on the mirror.
What exactly is the hard way?
We'll look through his things, his desk, everything. He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Smart enough to take a piece of the mirror? We can still solve this ourselves. I know
Never mind that. Come help me look.